Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Brett and I, Millimeter USA here, and this is going to be a review of the new Dan Wesson Point Man PM45 1911. Pretty excited about this one. This PM45 1911 is a continuation of Dan Wesson's Point Man 1911 series. They also offer this model in 9mm. It's called the PM9.
PM45. First rounds.
This 1911 is the government size, and it is chambered in 45 ACP. Hence the PM45. So PM45 for 45 ACP, PM9 for 9mm. We shot 250 rounds of this Sig Sauer Elite Performance ammunition during this review. Just regular ball ammo, a really good quality ammo for target shooting.
So in this 1911, we are going to be testing the Elander 1911 magazines, seen here. First one. Second one. Running good.
Most people consider these 1911s from Dan Wesson to be a semi-custom. They're built to exact tolerances and put together by hand by the folks at Dan Wesson. Everything on the 1911 is super tight, just like any of the custom pistols from Wilson or Nighthawk or anything like that. And you get these 1911s from Dan Wesson for a lot less money.
The Elander mag. Pulling myself off target a little bit.
So guys, do keep in mind that all the parts on these Dan Wessons are forged steel. There are no MEM or cast parts in these pistols, which is very evident in the overall quality of this 1911. You do pay a little bit more for this Dan Wesson, but I think the quality outshines everything else compared to many other manufacturers' 1911s. We're not new to Dan Wesson 1911s. This is our third one that we've shown in the channel. And each one has just been practically a masterpiece. Just very well made, shoots very well. Everything you could ever want from a 1911, no matter what the price point you're paying. Very impressive overall, guys. Highly recommended. This one comes in at about 41.3 ounces, so you do have some weight there, but that does translate to a smoother shooting 1911. Everything on the pistol is just near perfection. The slide to frame fit is just very good. The way this 1911 is put together, how tight the tolerances are, how beautifully this is done right here. You just don't see that in lesser 1911s. You really need to step up to the $3,000 area to get one that's made about as well as these Dan Wessons are, in our opinion. No overruns here, just machined to perfection. Not only good looking, but just the craftsmanship is
second to none.
It's just way up there. You have to step up to the real customs that are out there for 1911s to get close to this, and then you're paying $3,000 to $4,000. So if you're looking for something that you want that's top quality and not gonna break the bank, this one's right around $1,500.
The magwell in the frame of this 1911 has a slight beveling. As you can see right there, it's very well done, and that helps you get magazines in the gun easier. The mainspring on this 1911 has 25 lines per inch checkering. It's very nice, very well done. Helps lock into the pistol really good. And on the front strap here, again, 25 lines per inch checkering. Just very aggressive, feels fantastic in hand. Helps it not move around at all. Very well machined.
But not overly aggressive, which is what I really like about it.
That is true.
All right, guys, today's test with the Point Man 45 from Dan Wesson. The ammo is supplied by Elite Performance Ammunition from Sig Sauer. This is their 45 ACP ammo, 230 grain, traveling at 850 feet per second and 369 foot-pounds. Small headshot on that. I don't have the excuse for those.
Shoots really good, right?
The fiber optic sight helps a lot.
The Dan Wesson has a perfect size safety on it. This one is very positive and tight without being overly so, and very responsive to you as a shooter. For a right-handed shooter, just sweep it down, stay on top of it while you're shooting. If you change your mind, flip it back up. Just very nicely done.
And again, a forged part.
Yeah, won't have any problems with that breaking. Just a perfect safety. Well done by Dan Wesson. The PM45 has cocking serrations in the front and in the rear of the slide, making press checks or loading the pistol
press
very
check.
Easy and positive.
Yep, still loaded.
They're nice and aggressive, very easy to get a hold of.
They are, and they're not sharp, so they're aggressive. But you can't really, you know, hurt yourself or anything on them. The other thing about them is, let's see if we can get in a little closer here. Notice how in between the serrations it's sandblasted, and then the serrations themselves is this beautiful brushed stainless of the slide itself. That is attention to detail. I like it a lot. It's the little thing sometimes that make a big difference. One other thing that's very important to a lot of 1911 buyers out there is this a Series 70 or Series 80 1911? And as you can see, all Dan Wessons, as far as I know, are all Series 70s. It's something that young Beretta and I look for, and it does make a slight bit of difference to us. We prefer the Series 70 over the Series 80.
And it's also very traditional, this 1911, in that it has a internal extractor and not an external.
The PM45 has a recessed crown on the barrel itself. Very nicely done.
All right, guys, some more Elander magazine testing.
This PM45 from Dan Wesson also comes with a full-length guide rod assembly in it. So maybe not completely traditional 1911, but it is solid steel, and it probably does add a little bit of weight up front to help minimize recoil.
Looks very well made to me.
It's solid. I don't think there's anything that they do that's, you know, halfway done on these Dan Wesson 1911s. It's very well thought out and very well executed.
The PM45 has a beautiful finish to it. The flats on it are polished to a soft brush stainless finish, and the rounded edges are sandblasted for a nice contrast. You can see some of the sandblasting job right there on the lower half of the frame here and on top of the slide to reduce glare. Very well done. The Site C11 has an extended magazine release seen here. So the magazine release protrudes a little bit more from the frame than the standard magazine release you see on most 1911s. Very positive in its use. Does a great job. And it looks fantastic. It also has some checkering on it seen there.
It's just great attention to detail, even on that.
Yep.
The PM45 also has a nice undercut behind the trigger well here, so you can get that great high grip on your 1911. Just aids in control when you're shooting the handgun, and it feels pretty dang comfortable too. Loved it. The PM45 also comes stock with these double diamond Coco Bolo wood grips. Very attractive, quite grippy. Hope the camera's picking this up really well.
A nice pair of grips to finish off the look of this beautiful 1911, for sure.
Absolutely.
Let's go over the sight picture on this 1911. Back here you have a fully serrated, adjustable rear sight for both windage and elevation. In the front, you've got that awesome red fiber optic front sight. Looks great. And also while we're here, we should probably cover real fast the serration job on the top of the slide to reduce glare. So they have that there along with the sandblasting job on the top here, all to prevent glare. Very well done.
on the Pointman 45 from Dan Wesson, you get this new K-style stainless trigger in it. So it's not your traditional just circles or a solid trigger. It's a little bit different than some of the other things they offer there. And I believe it's new this year, right, young brother?
I believe so. We don't own any other 1911s that have this style of design other than this one, and it just looks fantastic.
On squeezing the trigger, you have this much take up. It firms up. And it breaks. So again, I'm squeezing the trigger here on the Pointman 45. Take up. About a 4 to 4.25 on the reset. As you let up your finger, it just immediately goes to reset. And then you've got a little movement going back. And another 4 to 4.25 pull.
Extremely audible reset and tactile.
Just great. The Pointman 45 comes with two excellent 7-round magazines from Dan Wesson. We're not easily impressed with stock magazines. This is our third Dan Wesson 1911, and all of these magazines from Dan Wesson have been very good. They say DW right there on them, 45 ACP. You can tell we used them a lot at the range, but the quality on these things has been great. They function flawlessly, and that's on the third Dan Wesson 1911. The other two were exactly the same, so I was not sure what the quality would be like, but you guys that go out and purchase a Dan Wesson 1911, I think at this point you can rest assured that these magazines, at least these magazines here, are going to work very well for you, and then you can add magazines to it if you want, whether it's a Wilson or a Trip or whatever, or an Elander for that matter, but the Dan Wesson magazines are going to work just great for you. I hope you guys enjoyed this review video of the Dan Wesson PM45, and if you're interested in this from Dan Wesson or anything else, go ahead and check out their products and website via the links in the description box below this review video. As always, everyone, thanks for watching the video. Remember to like, share, and subscribe to our channel here on YouTube, and consider joining us on our Patreon account, where we have behind-the-scenes actions and extra videos that are not on our regular YouTube page as a way to say thank you to all our patrons. That's it for now. See you guys at the next video.